or what we call JMOOC, a co-host. He will kindly share with us his keynote speak on the platform and portal level. So without further ado, could you please join me to welcome Professor Shirai.
Thank you very much. Yes, today, okay, I'll make our presentation in the style of the Bologna style. Have you been in Bologna? Still, there is a very old traditional classroom. You can sleep after the good lunch. Yes, it's my great pleasure and honor to attend and make a talk at the first Asian Pacific MOOC Stakeholders Summit. As I already mentioned, at first, MOOC is one of the most important social infrastructure in the modern civilized society. That means for the growth of nation, not only economic one, but knowledge base and cultural contents as MOOC is inevitable index to show the social and societal quality level. That is, people can feel mutually reliable each other and can be culturally active and live with certain amount of satisfaction. Nowadays, world is a connected one. We, for example, in MOOC, in each country, we have different MOOCs because we use each particular language in daily life. Language is the origin of each culture. Even so, we are sharing many things crossing borders. We should know each other and collaborate as in this conference. For that purpose, MOOC is one of the strongest tools. Without tight collaboration of MOOC, we cannot accomplish high level of national coordination in the future Asia-Pacific region. Today, I want to speak about the current state of the JMOOC and also the more general thing surrounding the MOOC.
There are three keywords of the 21st century: digitalization, globalization, and maturation. The first one, already digital native, rather dominates the majority. For example, the 43% of productive population will be digital native in 2020 in Japan. That is IBM Japan's focus. It is not necessary to stress again that digital technology change the world. MOOC may be the result of that technology. Of course, there were many open universities that are operating in each country. They use analog technology, TV broadcast or radio channels. But internet completely changed the way of distribution of the contents. And also the rapid growth of artificial intelligence or robotics technology, such technology give very serious impact on the human civilization. Some people say the singularity will come on 20th century and 45. Singularity means a basic change of the human race. True or not, I don't know. But at that time, artificial intelligence, AI teacher will appear, but also the learner might be AI. Then the totally, completely human excluded from the education process. That's a joke. Anyway, about the middle of the 20th century, 21st century, probably the ability of the computer will exceed human brain. That's true. The second keyword is globalization. Internet will accelerate globalization. For example, the YouTube, social media, Twitter, Facebook, Line, and so on. President Trump's make politics through Twitter. That's very, very okay. But globalization, the essence of the globalization may be occurred by the high-speed transportation or high-speed massive data transmission or like that. But that made a tight connection of the world, economically, or politically, or whole area of the cultural things. In that case, how we should think about the role of the MOOC in that, in this situation, MOOC can have the very important meaning we can expect. For example, cultural or lifestyle, food, religion, and so on can be exchanged by through the MOOC. That's very easy. Then we should make the MOOC put our stress such as people's living area relevant to the daily lives. The third keyword is maturation. Of course, still many countries on the stage of developing developing stage. They need elementary schools and so on. But on the other hand, in many countries, industrialization and information change brought a rather matured societies. We are discussing about the how to raise the QOL, and other things, but occurred by the side. That's the essential thing, but another difficult problems we encounter. For example, the enlarging gap between the rich and the poor. Only a grasp of wealthy people dominate the very large portion of the properties or assets of the world. That's very serious. And also in Japan, we have a very serious problem, I think. Now Japan's facing the serious problem on aging society. In 2020, aged people will exceed 30% of the total population. And the population decreases in local area. Already some small villages are vanishing in Japan. And also we have this problem of increase of pension and social insurance cost. This situation will occur in other areas equally. That's the time difference we have, but for example, China is a very large country, and also probably they have a more serious problem for the aging society. In this situation, what is possible? Probably we can save such kinds of society by the education, our way of education, I think. But until now, we constructed the educational system from the, for example, in Japan, 4 years old or like that, enters a kindergarten, and 6 years to the elementary school, and 12 years middle school, 15 years high school, and some people enter the university or vocational school, so-called higher education, in 18 years. But they graduate, finish the conventional educational system only in 20s, 22, 23, or 5, or like that. Of course, that situation is slightly different country and country. Average of the university students' age is probably exceeds 25 or like that, I think. But in Japan, almost university students enter 18 years old. They're very young. Then they almost all the people in the world now finish the education on the 25 or until 25 or like that. But nowadays we can survive until more than 70 or 80, or in Japan nearly 90. Then so many years without educational, they leave the educational from the educational system. Of course, lifelong learning has been planned for many years. But the lifelong learning is not so popular, probably in this world. Then we should make a new system of education after 20 or 30. I recommend such kinds of education should be compulsory, because we include the master course or doctor degree, a master degree, that education or training system is very much different from the nature or characteristics of the lifelong learning. The purpose is very much different. Then we should make a new system of education. That is one system maybe we can expect for the MOOC. We should develop MOOC in that sense. Why? The educational system, the purpose of the educational system until now, conventional system, is aiming the education or training for every individual, not necessarily for the massive training or of course some are massive and collective training that include, but most education is individual basis. Learner can learn and obtain something for the work or other things. But some kinds of social learning is very important. I don't mean the social learning is not the training such as in the military training or some kinds of totalizationism. No. Because, for example, in the MOOC, there are many, many varieties in many countries, in many areas, depending on the cultural things or histories and so on. Then we can understand and learn from the international MOOC system. We can wide variety of the human race. Through the such kinds of education or learning, we can make a more advanced society. I expect such kinds of things to in the activity of the JMOOC. Anyway, here I would like to say only the very small portion of the age we can take the suitable training or education. But after that, we don't have the suitable chance to study. We establish such kinds of system that is more international. Then the open education is very, very important. For example, I imagine, of course, in MOOC, we can treat the religious things. There are many conflicts in the world now, local conflict, but there are many. But we should put our arms or weapons aside first and join in the MOOC and discuss each other. We refrain such kinds of process. We can reach the some kinds of the consideration of the conflict resolution or like that. Okay. About the JMOOC story. JMOOC was established in 2013. And now first course was operated 2014 April. Now we are offering 172 courses. That were provided from the universities, mostly from universities. This is the area of the subjects from the JMOOC. Humanities 25 and so on. And very good balance, I think. Now, until now, the JMOOC enrollment is nearly more than 500,000. But not so remarkable. Only the linearly increasing. This is a runner's profile about the age. I think the distribution is flat, and also the educational background. Undergraduate is more than half. And about the profession, full-time worker, 60%. No occupation, very few, only 15%. Members of MOOC. JMOOC is supported by the these members, special members, six companies, and regular members, 50 universities and 32 companies, and other supporting members. It is important, the JMOOC mission statement. JMOOC strongly leads and aims to bring to to a reality MOOC's vision to expand individual values to the whole of society's shared values through learning for Japan and Asia based on business academia collaboration. Now, JMOOC aiming mainly these directions. Enlarging social recognition of MOOC certificate. That is not enough now, current state. Establishment of social infrastructure for lifelong learning. About the lifelong learning in Japan, Open University of Japan, a very strong organization. But the MOOC is aiming a different area. And also the cooperation and alliance among Asian countries. And also the we are aiming the establishment of methodology for flipped learning and the learning analytics area. This is JMOOC's organization skips here. JMOOC's special features is we are not dependent
on specific organization, like huge company, nor foundation, or not for the government, on in a very independent organization, operated by the only the membership dues, then very poor organization. Course delivery is not only from top-ranked universities, but including the second or third years of universities. Various, many kinds of universities provide the courses. Courses almost in Japanese. And also we are depending on the multi-platform. Gakko is from the NTT, Docomo company. Open learning, that's a learning. OU JMOOC, that's open university. FISDAM, provided from the Fujitsu company. Current program of the JMOOC is the first one is a financial program, depending on the our fees, dues. And the second one, then the, we should develop some kinds of business to earn the money. And the third one is we should develop a new style of lifelong learning. That means, first I mentioned, lifelong learning should have, if in the worldwide sense, in what way we can accomplish the our objectives of the MOOC or lifelong education purpose. This is the last conference in Tokyo. March 3rd, 2016, in Meiji University campus. Then, this time, the first Asia Pacific stakeholder summit, very successful meeting here we have. Then we can expect possibility of the cooperation, course exchanges, and of course, we are using the Japanese language, then how to translate or such kinds of technical things is maybe a problem. And also we have sharing various experiences that is maybe depending on the country or region, but that experiences are very fruitful for each other.
And also the learning analytics and some technologies for the development of efficient courses. Probably we can cooperate in this area in the next step.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Professor Shirai, for